Daniel Bryan addressed his speculation on his current WWE contract. Andrade challenges Kenny Omega at Triplemania 29, and Kenny responds. And WWE great compares Roman Reigns to Brock Lesnar, CM Punk, Steve Austin, and The Undertaker. Hello everyone, Jose G here bringing you today's top stories in today's Sportskeeda Wrestling News Roundup. Daniel Bryan addresses speculation on his current WWE contract. Daniel Bryan's WWE contract expires soon, but not in September like many previously believed. Before his Universal Championship match on SmackDown last week against Roman Reigns, Daniel Bryan sat down with Keisha Hatchett of TV Line to discuss his future in wrestling. When Hatchett brought up the fact that Bryan's WWE contract was expiring in September, the leader of the Yes Movement surprisingly shot that down by saying, quote, "It's funny that people gravitate towards the date, September, and I think it's because that's when my last contract ended, but that doesn't end in September. I'm still trying to figure out what that looks like. You get to the point where it's like, how long can I do this full time and still be able to do those kind of things with my daughter? What's the right balance between part-time and that sort of thing? It may be that it's just every once in a while when the urge strikes, or maybe like a schedule where it's like 8 months on, these months off," end quote. Daniel Bryan was tight-lipped when it came to his WWE contract expiring, but it's believed to be at some point this year. Bryan believes that being an independent contractor in the wrestling business gives him the right to decide his workload each year. That's something we're sure that if WWE doesn't agree with, another company out there will. By saying, quote, "One of the coolest things about wrestling and just being an independent contractor in general is that you can say, well, I really only want to do this amount of work. What that amount of work is, I have no idea yet. I still have to figure it out, but I also need to be respectful of the people who are relying on me to go to work. I have to give them an answer sooner rather than later. I'm trying to figure that out, trying to be responsible as an employee of somebody who's taking care of our family very well, but then also trying to take the time to figure it out," end quote. Chris Jericho slams WWE booking. WWE legend and current AEW star Chris Jericho is set to be part of the first ever AEW Blood and Guts match. The namesake show is set to take place on May 5th, 2021, where Chris Jericho and the rest of the Inner Circle will take on the Pinnacle. Ahead of the match, Chris Jericho appeared on Busted Open Radio and compared AEW's booking of the match to that of WWE's booking of Hell in a Cell matches. Y2J criticized WWE for not using the gimmick match properly and randomly putting together a story leading to the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view event. Chris Jericho emphasized the fact that a match has to fit the story and not vice versa, saying, quote, "I'm a big proponent that the match has to fit the story, not a story just to have the match. For example, Hell in a Cell. Oh, we've got Hell in a Cell pay-per-view coming up next month. Let's put together a three-week story and put them in a cell. Then we'll have a tag team in the cell. We have a woman's cell. We'll have a midget cell. It's like you're prostituting this gimmick. For Blood and Guts, the story needs to be there first. And for the first time since last March, we have this story between these two factions that right out of the gate, there's a lot of intensity and a lot of interest. So let's put it in Blood and Guts," end quote. During his run with WWE, Chris Jericho competed in a Hell in a Cell match once. This happened at Judgment Day 2002 when he took on Triple H. It was Triple H who won the match by pinning Jericho at the top of the cell after hitting him with a pedigree. Since 2009, WWE has made Hell in a Cell an annual pay-per-view. In the last few years, there has been a lot of criticism of WWE for devaluing the concept of a gimmick match like Hell in a Cell. The criticism has been focused on the company throwing random feuds into the match type without a proper build-up. Andrade challenges Kenny Omega at Triplemania 29, Kenny responds. Andrade has been at the center of headlines since his sudden departure from WWE this past March. After the recent announcement of his independent match against Alberto El Patron, another big match seems to be in the pipeline. At this weekend's AAA Rey de Reyes event, Andrade teased a CMLL invading faction and made a challenge. Andrade has challenged the current AAA Mega Champion, new Impact World Champion and reigning AEW World Champion Kenny Omega to a title match at Triplemania 29. This has to be considered one of the biggest potential matches of the year, with AAA bringing in a former WWE talent to meet the top star in AEW. The news follows the announcement that Andrade will be part of the new Mexican-based promotion, Federacion Wrestling, alongside his friend ROH World Champion Rush and talent from AEW. Andrade has definitely wasted no time in creating a wave of momentum and buzz around him since his departure from WWE. Along with his monumental challenge to Kenny Omega, Andrade teased a new faction coming to AAA. In his promo for the AAA Rey de Reyes event, the former WWE United States Champion teased a group of CMLL talent coming into the top promotion in Mexico. With Andrade's ties to Rush and Dragon Lee, it would not be a surprise to see these two men join him in AAA. The current AEW Impact and AAA Mega Champion Kenny Omega has now taken to Twitter to respond to Andrade's challenge by saying that he is a busy guy and needs some time to think about it. If he accepts the challenge, the bout against Andrade has the potential to be an instant classic. Kenny Omega is one of the most popular wrestlers in the business today. Almost every match he is a part of is amazing, and he continues to deliver five-star matches on a regular basis. His work ethic and in-ring ability are so good that he now finds himself with three championship belts in his possession. This has also put a target on his back, with potential threats emerging for all three titles. Cesaro predicts the results of next week's SmackDown with a hilarious post. The Swiss cyborg Cesaro is scheduled to take on Seth Rollins on next week's episode of SmackDown. This will be their first meeting in a one-on-one match since WrestleMania 37, where Cesaro defeated Rollins. Now the Messiah looks to next Friday's SmackDown throwback episode to exact his revenge. However, Cesaro has other plans and recently gave a very straightforward prediction for the match with a hilarious post on Twitter. The former United States champion posted some fan art on his Twitter handle that portrays him as the protagonist of the popular anime One Punch Man. The protagonist Saitama is famous for being able to end his matches in one punch. Clearly, Cesaro is confident in his abilities and predicts he will win the match with ease, or more precisely, with one punch. The fan art itself is an accurate representation of how this feud between Cesaro and Seth Rollins has been going so far. Rollins seems unnecessarily riled up about Cesaro, whereas the Swiss Superman isn't even bothered by the threat posed by the former WWE champion. Cesaro will be looking to finally put an end to this feud with Seth Rollins as he looks to move on to bigger and better things. The latest episode of SmackDown saw Daniel Bryan lose to Roman Reigns in the main event. His loss means that Bryan will not be able to perform on the Blue Brand for the foreseeable future. His loss came as a huge blow to his good friend Cesaro. Cesaro posted a picture on Instagram later that night paying tribute to the American Dragon, thanking him for all he has done for him. He also sent a message to Roman Reigns stating that he will be coming for him in the future. The Swiss Superman has his sights set on taking the Universal Championship away from Reigns, and many expect him to challenge the Tribal Chief at WrestleMania Backlash. WWE Great compares Roman Reigns to Brock Lesnar, CM Punk, Steve Austin, and The Undertaker. Paul Heyman said on the latest episode of Talking Smack that Roman Reigns' level of greatness is something he has never seen before. Reigns' on-screen special counsel has worked with some of the biggest names in wrestling history, including Brock Lesnar, CM Punk, Steve Austin, and The Undertaker. Paul Heyman said that he took a kid under his wing in WCW and delivered him to the doorstep of Vince McMahon when the time was appropriate. The kid turned out to be WWE icon The Undertaker. Highlighting how long he has been associated with the brains behind true greatness, Heyman also mentioned three other marquee names by saying, quote, "Of course, when it came time for that Faustian bargain to be collected, the streak was conquered by my beast. I was with Steve Austin before he was Stone Cold. If you watch the A&E documentary on Steve Austin, he gives me credit for putting the Stone Cold mindset inside his psyche. I was also the voice of the voice of the voiceless," end quote. Following Reigns' victory over Bryan on WWE SmackDown, Heyman claimed he is in awe of the WWE Universal Champion by saying, quote, "You look at the greatness that I've been associated with, that I've driven, that I've inspired for 34 years in this business? And what am I with Roman Reigns? Forget about being the special counsel. I'm in awe of Roman Reigns. This is a GOAT level of all GOAT levels. I've never seen greatness like this," end quote. The term GOAT is used to describe someone who is considered the greatest of all time. WWE superstars and legends, including Becky Lynch and Ric Flair, have also referred to themselves as WWE's GOAT. Roman Reigns does not refer to himself as the GOAT on WWE TV. However, Seth Rollins recently said WWE fans should be blessed to have witnesses of two GOAT performers in himself and Reigns at the same time. Thanks for watching today's Sportskeeda Wrestling News Roundup. For more news stories and exclusive content, be sure to follow us on all social media. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. Download the Sportskeeda app for the most up-to-date stories in the world of wrestling.